Hello, everyone. I am Tace here. I'm one of the PMs working on Visual Studio. And today I would like to talk to you about some tips and tricks for the Git tooling in Visual Studio 2022. Let's get started by looking at stashing in Visual Studio. Stashing is a useful feature when you have changes that you are not ready to commit and need to switch and work on something different. To stash your changes in Visual Studio, open the Git Changes window, provide your stash message, and then use the Commit All dropdown, choose to stash all. This is your stash. When you are ready to go back to your changes, right-click on your stash and choose Apply or Pop, depending on if you would like to keep your stash or not. In this case, I don't need to keep my stash, so I'll use the pop option. And this is our change. Next, I'm going to be talking to you about adding other remote repositories to your Git repository. Git calls the remote repository you clone from origin. Sometimes you need to add other remote repositories to collaborate with others. To add a remote repository, you first need the repository URL. In this example, I'm going to use the repository that I have forked from as a remote repository. A quick way to get the URL is to use the additional menu on the side and click on Open in Browser. Once you do that, your browser should open and take you to the GitHub page where that repository is hosted. And then you will just need to click on the forked from link, which will take you to the original repository. Once you get there, just get the repository URL. And then go back to Visual Studio, click on the additional operations link, and click on Manage Remotes. You'll see that my origin is already there. And so what I will need to do now is click on Add and paste the URL that we have just copied from the browser. And I'm going to name this a forked from. Then feel free to save, click OK, and then just fetch. Once you do that, Visual Studio automatically adds in the other repository as an additional remote repository. Next, I would like to talk to you about getting updates from branches other than your tracking branch. Getting updates from branches other than your remote tracking branch is useful if you need to get the latest updates that your colleagues have been working on, or if you are working on a fork and need to get updates from the original repository that you forked from. A quick way to do that in Visual Studio is by utilizing the branch picker on the Git Changes window or the status bar. By clicking there, going to the Remotes tab, right-clicking on the remote branch, and then choosing Merge into Current Branch. In this case, I'm going to be getting the latest update from main on the original repository that I have forked from into my local main. Once you do that, you get a success message indicating that that has been successful. To speed up your flow, you can pin the branches that you are actively working on by right-clicking on any branch and selecting Pin to Top. If you just need to get your remote tracking branches updates, it's easier to use the Pull From feature in the Additional Operations menu. Now, let's review the latest updates by clicking on the outgoing incoming link. Doing that opens the Git repository window, where you can see the latest updates that we have been able to get from the other remote branch. Feel free to double click on any one of these commits and browse the different commits by looking at the commit details and the diff next to it. Once you are ready, feel free to click the push button to push all the latest changes into your remote branch. Next, I would like to talk to you about cleaning up your commits using the squash feature. It is a good practice to commit regularly. As you can see here, I've been working on a bug fix and ended up completing the work with two commits. Visual Studio can combine these two commits and clean up the Git history through the squash feature. To do that, use the Control key on your keyboard to select the commits that you would like to combine. Right click, select squash commit. That would bring up the squash dialog, which would allow you to update your commit message. So in this case, we can say that we are fixing our bug, and then click squash, and Visual Studio combines both commits for us. So now we can go ahead and push our clean history to our remote branch. And finally, the last tip that I would like to share with you today is on Git Settings. If you need to change the behavior of the Git tooling in Visual Studio, there is a high chance that you can do that using the Git Settings functionality. A quick way to get to your Git Settings is through the top-level Git menu by clicking on Settings. Once you are in there, you'll be able to change your global repository settings and your Git repository settings. For example, I can change my email address, enable force pushing, and even tweak and change how Visual Studio behave when switching between repositories. On the repository setting page, I get the ability to edit my ignore and attributes files as well. So clicking edit here would open my .gitignore file where I can make any tweaks I need to make. Thanks everyone for listening. I hope this was helpful and informative. Make sure to check more of our VS 2022 videos and see you around. Bye.